Kathleen Oma, and welcome to our reaction to C.W. McCall. And we're going to react to the song, There Won't Be No Country Music.
Oh.
Will this be a country music or no? I can't
take
this.
First time single take honest reaction by both of us. Let's check it out. Let's get started.
It's only going to be about an hour, friend, to let dam your favorite river so you can water ski just one more reservoir. And them supersonic ships are going to take you across a sea of pavement to one more faceless brickyard on the shore. Yeah, it's only going to be about an hour or so till they rip off all your mountains, boy, and that one last tired old eagle bites the sand. And all of that high and mighty scenery is going to be leveled to the ground, boy, by a bunch of them mindless strip mines on the land.
So listen well, my brothers, when you hear the night wind sigh and you see the wild goose flying through the gray polluted sky. There won't be no country music, there won't be no rock and roll, 'cause when they take away our country, they'll take away our soul.
It's only going to take about a minute or so till the junkyards fill the prairies, boy, and them smoking yellow grass fires start to burn. And the warnings on them beer cans going to be buried in them landfills. No deposit, no sad songs, and no return. Yeah, it's only going to take about a minute or so till the factories blot the sun out, and you're going to have to turn your lights on just to see. Them lights are gonna be neon, saying fly our jets to paradise, and the whole damn world's gonna be made of styrene.
So listen well, my brothers, when you hear the night wind sigh and you see the wild goose flying through the gray polluted sky. There won't be no country music, there won't be no rock and roll, 'cause when they take away our country, they'll take away our soul.
It's only going to be about a second, boy, till they take away all of this country, and they'll tell you not to listen to this here song. And that far-off sound of freedom's going to be an echo from the past, and the final tune is going to be sad and long. And it's only going to be about an eye blink, boy, till they pull out the wool of blindness, so we just can't read all the messages on the wall. But the only words that matter ought to be scribbled all over them billboards in big old black and bloody letters.
There won't be no country music, there won't be no rock and roll, 'cause when they take away our country, they'll take away our soul. There won't be no country music, there won't be no rock and roll, 'cause when they take away our country, they'll take away our soul. There won't be no country music, there won't be no rock and roll, 'cause when they take away our country, they'll take away our soul.
This sounded good. I like the voice of C.W. McCall and then the backup singers too. They made a good song. They definitely made a good song. It had a lot of things going. The primary tune of the stringed instrument that started the song, I was thinking, is it going to be some kind of country music or what? But this is a different song. This is an awareness song. This is an environmental song. And it went well. For me, it went well. The musical elements also went well. It is put together well and it sounds good to listen to. And it will go well for, outdoor things or events as well where you play this. People will get the message very easily. Of course, it's talking about mainly America and how things will change for them. There won't be any country music, no rock and roll. You know, there won't be a country and there won't be a soul and things like that. When we let the things happen the way they are going, and factories, industrialization, or rampant destruction of the environment. So it is for basically written with the context of America, but different countries can put their own this thing, whatever is their charm or what they want to put.
Yes, I think it would be fair enough to say that C.W. McCall lives in a little shack in the forest. He has no car, he has no electricity, and he doesn't use any of those products which those same industries in America are producing. So he has no phone, he has no stereo system, he has no
electric guitar, no guns.
He has all those things that he's talking about that are destroying his country, his culture, their very soul. I guess he's not using any of them, and so too are all the people who worked on the song with him.
Yeah.
That would be nice. That would be a nice gesture if that happened. But I dare say I don't think that ever has happened. Any of these artists, you, the moment you hear something like that and you see their own very lives on social media, it's pathetic how they even stand there and sing that on stage. Anyway, the fact is it was a good song. It, for me, it has a lot of meaning. Back home in India, yes, I don't have a car. I have never driven a car in my life. You know, I mean, I'm almost done. I just have a few years left in me. I've never driven a car, nor do I even have hopes of doing so or owning one either. I don't have a driver's license. The one that I had has expired ages ago. And that was also for a two-wheeler, not a four-wheeler. So that is my little contribution. When it came to the environment, years ago I had a choice. Either make it big as a book publisher, book writer, and sell books of my lectures and various principles I taught to thousands of people in my country, or to go another way and keep the trees intact, or do my bit to keep the trees intact. So I chose to make audiobooks and then make videos. So I took a different road. And thank God that I did. You know, so when I talk here about these things, I may not be taken seriously, but at least I go to bed soundly at night for the job that I've done. You know, I'm not out there destroying the planet and then pretending to be a saint at the same time. If you get my drift, but I don't think you will, because your boat has sailed far enough that you can't even see the next horizon or the one you left behind.
Also, we don't have air conditioners and we don't like one.
There are lots of things we don't have, and it's not about us personally. You know, when what infuriates me in a song like this or with reactions like this is sitting here and saying the same thing again, because there might be, I hope one day I'm wrong, and I hope one day there is an actual saint out there like Mother Teresa, who's actually doing work, because I've seen Mother Teresa personally doing her work when she was alive. I've been blessed by her. I've been blessed by two saints, the late Saint Mother Teresa and the late Saint Pope John Paul II. So I've seen Mother Teresa up close, because I lived in a part of Mumbai, South Mumbai, where she had one of her biggest charity works is still running there probably till today, called Ashadan. So I've seen it up close, because it was a hop, skip and a jump from my old building, the old place where we live, mansion. You know, I don't think there's going to be another Mother Teresa ever.
I would say that is wrong to say. In India, most people...
Yeah, in India, there are. No, I'm saying in that part of the world.
People.
Because she was originally from the West.
Yeah, yeah.
She came here, she became and Indian, she adopted Indian. The culture, she adopted everything. She became India's favorite child.
For India, it's
and
not
daughter.
Just, you know, work, earn, spend. Work, earn, spend. That is the philosophy in the West. You work, you earn, and the money you earn, you have to spend it on yourself and on your luxury, on your convenience, on your comfort. But it does not go the same way here. We do work, we do earn, but we spend in a different way. It's always not to do with the class, and always everything doesn't have to do with the society and what is the trend, what people are using, what they are not using. That is where the culture comes in place. That is where culture plays a major role in India, because culturally we don't have to do what everybody else is doing, though it is pushed down the throat of the people every day and night. The moment you start social media, the moment you start television, the moment you start any kind of media, it's being pushed down the throat for people. But still people have resisted a long, long, long time now. And if it continues this way, I think just being an Indian, you will be a great environment soldier. Because of our culture.
Each of us are in our very own ways. Yeah. Almost every Indian is a tremendous human being to have on this planet. And it's a shame that people are not learning the right things from us. You know, when they learn things about us, they probably aren't learning the right things. And I'm not talking about yoga and Ayurveda.
That is for your well-being.
And Bollywood and things like that. I'm not talking about all those
Bollywood
kind of
things. Bollywood don't learn
anything. Overall, I'm talking about in general our lifestyle, the way we live, there's a lot to learn. You know, I put on this t-shirt which looks like an American t-shirt or something like that just for these videos. You know, I have no real need for t-shirts like these otherwise. You know, I love where I come from, and to just to connect with you, I have to mirror the lifestyle and little bit of the clothing from there. And so this is it, and same goes for Kirti. But deep down, the way we live our lives, our culture, our food, the way we celebrate things, the way we live each day is so different from what we see on the other side of the world. I mean, the same people who make songs like that, this is not the first one, mind you, that we've heard like that. It may be the 50th or 60th one we've heard in the last 2 years or so on this platform alone. So when we speak, it's not just based on this song. So don't get us wrong that, oh, why are we saying it for this song? The song was actually really good to listen to.
It
had good substance
kind of
as
song.
Well. Good substance in the lyrics. It was beautifully sung. Good country music song. It had a bit of folk-like vibe to it. You know, the folk music of bluegrass as well as folk music of the southern part of America. So it had those vibes in it, which I like. But
The reality,
I mean, you can see it all around you. The reality is right out there, you know, in the world. And there's no hiding from it. There's no hiding from it. And I guess that's the message of the song. So hopefully you take whatever we said with a pinch of salt, maybe, because that's what you usually do. And hence 70% of the population there is on drugs, prescription or unprescribed. If you get my drift. Sad. You know, by the way, coming to the point, I thought country music and rock music in America was already dead.
Yeah, actually.
It's already dead.
So this song may be old.
You know, this song is quite old.
Yeah.
I think it's already dead.
Yeah.
It may still be existing.
More
it may have award
More
shows.
Yes.
It may have some icons out there who pretend
but
to keep it
all
alive.
Old generation.
But it's already dead. It's already dead. So what on earth is being spoken about? But I guess it's about maybe 50s, 60s. There was a big nuclear bomb, and we all know the only time atomic energy was used for destruction of other men was by America. Thank you, America. Thank you for bombing us. For bombing us and killing thousands of innocent children, women, men, old people.
Birds,
thank you.
Animals, everything died.
Yeah, until today people are suffering.
Trees and everything.
In that part of the world. So thank you, America. Thank you for this song and for enlightening us about the use of such resources. We all know who uses them, and we also know who abuses them. So that's the truth. That's the reality of it all. There's a limit to what you can say in one reaction video. So I'll end right here, because you know it's downright shameful. You know, when we read the comments on such videos, it's downright shameful that people actually try to go against whatever we said when we actually sing the same thing what this guy is saying, to live it.
Yeah.
You know, don't just sing it, live it. But you'll always get nasty guys, and that itself reveals the culture of the entire population.
Yeah.
It's not about one or two people out of four or five or six who comment. It's about the entire population is just standing by and letting it happen. And that is the greater damage. You know, it's whether you talk about domestic violence, abuse, physical, sexual, and all that. We all know the statistics. We all know how high it is in that part of the world. So, you know, it's time to own up for the mistakes you made. It's time, you know, I would like to listen to a song for a change that I'm sorry, Earth, I bombed you, I keep bombing you, I keep running my nuclear test, I keep, you know, producing weapons of mass destruction, I keep producing more and more guns, I keep shaming my culture and a lot of other people on social media for no reason at all. I keep doing this, I keep doing that. I dress like a weirdo, I live like a weirdo, I am a weirdo, I'm sorry for it all. So I wish there were songs like that, you know, based on how they actually are. The reality of it all and the fiction of it all.
That is true.
Yeah,
but
at the end of the day, it's fictional, right? It's all fiction. It's all art. They say it's all art. It's art. Savio, it's art. Kirti, it's art. You guys don't get it. It's art.
Oh, let's live in the real world then.
Yeah, it's right? Art. We know a lot about art. Don't we?
Welcome Cafe Noma and welcome to our reaction to Black Betty Smoke. And we are going to react to the song Everybody Knows She's Mine.
She smiled at me and kissed my cheek. I'm thinking, Lord, I must be living right. I ain't about to say I ain't lucky, but some might say I'm a fool, yeah. But chances are I'm doing fine so far, 'cause her mama even said I'm cool. Look out. She gets me high as a Georgia pine. Why? Summertime. Yeah, everybody knows she's mine. That's right. Well, there might be a couple kind of like her, but rest assured, brother, this one mine. I'll be right there in her back pocket. She got my name tattooed where the sun don't shine. Saw you looking when she walked in with me. I don't blame you, she's a hell of a girl, man. I know how you feel, it ain't no big deal. I'm the luckiest man in the world, yeah. She gets me high as a Georgia pine, wild as a muscadine vine, hotter than the deep south summertime. Yes, everybody knows she's mine. That's right. Get it. Yeah, oh, oh, oh. Yeah, nah, nah. Thank you.
sheet man.
Oh wow, that piano made everything sound special. Much better. Yeah, I like that piano. It had a special appearance, though the drums were good too. The drums were pretty dominant in the song, but the piano keys, that's what were driving the entire emotion. It was literally like the emotions were flowing through the piano keys. There was a female singer too who joined in later. I could hear in the background. I like his voice, Blackberry. It sounds more familiar as John Prine or something.
Reminded me a little bit of Blues Traveler's vocals.
Blues Traveler.
Little bit. The style and the way of the way he sings.
Hmm.
Yeah, Blackberry Smoke. We have heard Blackberry Smoke before.
Okay.
Maybe that's why it sounds familiar.
Mm-hmm. And I like his story. The way he sings sounds more genuine.
Mm.
It sounds like he means everything he's saying.
Yeah, that's true.
His voice is, his way of singing is where the song
it's
is.
It's pure, it's raw. Yeah. It has that earthy vibe, you know.
Yeah.
So you kind of connect with it better. It's a common man's story.
It's a common man's story. I like the first two lines, the opening lines. She looks so beautiful in the morning and she looks better than last night too. That was cute, the way he put it. She looked good last night, but she looks even better today.
Mm.
So it keeps getting better for him every day with her and he's just happy. Everybody knows that.
You know, one thing, everybody knows she's mine. He was saying that a few times.
Yeah.
At the end, it sounded like he's saying everybody knows she's not mine.
Oh, I didn't pay attention to that.
That's what it felt like, but I'm sure I'm wrong.
It would be heartbreaking for
him. I'm sure I'm wrong.
He was very...
But upset. I don't know, for some reason it sounded like everybody knows she's not mine.
Okay.
I'm probably imagining it. It's a good song.
It's a good song.